Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. In this channel, you will learn about data science using real examples and demonstrations. In this video, I will talk about time series analytics. Time is present in most of the data around us, from retail product sales to financial stock price to IoT sensor data, all have the notion of time in it. So mastering the time series analytics is going to make you the master of the data science universe. The top 5 techniques which I will demonstrate in this video are seasonality detection to find peaks in the retail product sales, dynamic time wrap to find products with similar sales patterns, autocorrelation to identify uptrending financial stocks, change point detection to better understand the changes in the stock price trends, and fast Fourier transforms to make the workload planning. So we have a very packed agenda, my friends. So let's get started. But before that, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and like and comment on the video. In this example, I'll be using data on retail product sales to demonstrate seasonality detection. The data consists of product month and the sales for the month. And seasonality means that some specific months have higher sales compared to others. Let us take an example of the product Rabbit Nightlight. This graph shows the sales of this product by month. The data is for the year 2019 and 2020. As you can see that this product has got a peak in November 2019. And then this peak repeats itself in the month of November 2020. This means that there is a seasonality in the sales data for this product Rabbit Nightlight. Now, this way of manually looking at the sales graph and determining the seasonality is good. But when you have thousands of products, you need an automated way to determine seasonality. And this is where the seasonality detection algorithms can help. Here is the result of seasonality detection algorithm applied to multiple products. On the x-axis, you have the time taken for the sales peak to repeat itself. And on the y-axis, you have an indication on how high is the peak. So our product Rabbit Nightlight is situated here. And the seasonality detection has estimated that the sales peak would repeat itself every 12 to 13 months, which means that there is one sales peak in a year. Now let us look at some other products. For example, this one. This is World War II Gliders Assorted Design product, which has got a sales peak every 6 months. This means that there will be two sales peak in a year. Here is the sales trend for the product World War II Gliders. We can see that this product has got a peak in the month of April 2019 and then another peak in the month of October 2019, and then this peak repeats itself in the month of April 2020 and October 2020. So you can see that the seasonality detection is a very powerful way to detect number of sales peak automatically and without looking at individual sales graph for each product. It also helps in correctly planning the stock levels for the products. Let us now move into a very interesting algorithm called the dynamic time wrap. The name of this algorithm may sound like a time machine, but we are going to use it to find products which have similar sales pattern in our retail data. Here is the result of the dynamic time wrap applied on the retail data. Each dot represents two products. If the dot is more on the left, means that the two products have got similar sales patterns. As per this algorithm, the products Woodland Charlotte Bag and Jumbo Bag Baroque have got similar sales patterns. If I move to the right, I will see products which have completely dissimilar sales patterns. In this case, we have the cake case and the rabbit night light, which have completely dissimilar sales patterns. Now let us first look into the sales related to the Woodland Sherlock bag and Jumbo bag Baroque and see how similar are the sales patterns. Here are the sales for the product Woodland Sherlock bag and the Jumbo bag Baroque. Now both the products have got similar sales pattern, and both the products have got a peak in the month of March and a peak in the month of June and then a peak in the month of August. And after that, the sales for both products reduce. Now, even if the quantity of the two products are not exactly the same, the algorithm is able to correctly identify these two products having similar sales pattern. Let us now look into the sales for the cake case and the rabbit night light, which have been identified by the algorithm as the products which have completely dissimilar sales pattern. The rabbit night light, which is shown here in gray, has got one sales peak in a year, but the cake case, which is shown in orange, has got multiple sales peaks. So as you can see that the algorithm is highly intelligent and it is correctly able to identify similar and dissimilar sales patterns, and it really justifies its sophisticated name. Now this can be very useful in supply chain and logistic planning, as it helps to group similar products together for logistical purposes. Let us now move to financial trading. In this example, I will take stocks from CAC 40, which is the French stock market. Stock data is essentially a time series data, and we can apply data science algorithms to do some cutting edge analysis on the stock data. In this section, I'll be talking about autocorrelation, and let me start with a conceptual example. Let us say we have a stock whose stock price chart looks something like this. Now, as you can see that the price on the day 9 has increased and the price on the day 8 has decreased. This means that there is a negative correlation between the day 9 and the previous day. Now, on the other hand, the price on the day 9 has increased, but the price on the day 7 has also increased. This means that there is a positive correlation between the day 9 and the day minus 2. Now, with this understanding, you will be able to better understand autocorrelation. Here is the result of autocorrelation applied to some of the stocks in the French stock market. Each stock is shown as a separate color. So for example, the dark blue color corresponds to the stock symbol ABIO. Now let us take this dot, which shows a correlation between any day and the previous day. And here we see the correlation value of 0.99. Now, correlation values which are close to 1 means there is a very high positive correlation. Now, this means that if the price on any day has increased, the price for the previous day has also increased. Now, let us take the dot over here, and which shows the correlation between any day and 10 days before. And we see that the correlation value of 0.9. Which means if the price for any day has increased, the price for the period 10 days before has also increased. Now similarly, this dot shows the correlation between any day and the day 19 days before. And we see a positive correlation value of 0.85, which means that if the price for any day has increased, the price for the period 19 days before has also increased. Now this shows that the price of ABIO have been generally increasing. In general, higher the stocks in this visualization means that these are uptrending stocks. Now more bottom you go in the visualization, this means that the stocks have low correlation between different periods. So for example, if you take the stock symbol Amun, you will see that the correlation value is generally around 0.2 and 0.3. This means that there is not much correlation between the stock prices for different periods. And this indicates that these are the stocks which do not have any clear trend. So here is the stock price chart for the stock symbol ABIO. This stock price chart is from the beginning of 2020 to beginning of 2021. And as you can see that this stock price chart is generally uptrending. Now here is the stock price chart for the stock symbol Amun. This is also from beginning of 2020 to beginning of 2021. And as you can see that this stock doesn't have any clear trend. First it is decreasing and after that it was increasing and then decreasing again. So as you can see that autocorrelation is a very powerful way to get insights into the stock trends. You can also run autocorrelation on multiple stocks and identify uptrending stocks in one go rather than analyzing each stock individually. Let us now talk about another cutting edge algorithm called the change point detection. Now here is the price chart for the stock symbol Amun between February 2020 and March 2021. Now we see that this stock has got a downtrend followed by an uptrend and then again a downtrend. Now with the change point detection algorithm, we can exactly plot where the change in the trend has happened. Here is the result of the change point detection algorithm. The algorithm has detected four change points which are indicated here with these blue vertical lines. Now with these vertical lines, we can easily identify the time periods for each trend. Also, we can see the timing of each change point. So we had a change point around February 2020. And then we had another change point around March 2020. The next change point was around June 2020. And then the last change point was around November 2020. Now this means that the duration of each trend is around 3 to 4 months. And with the last change point around November 2020, we should expect a trend change in the coming months. In this section, we will talk about fast Fourier transformation. It is claimed to be one of the most widely used algorithms on the planet. It has got various applications from satellite communication to image compression. And in this section, we will use it for workforce planning. This example is around 911 phone calls from the Montgomery County in the USA. The data has got date, hour, and number of calls received. Now this is also a time series data as the number of calls depend on the date and the time. If you plot a line curve, it will look like this. On the x-axis, you have the time, and on the y-axis, you have the number of calls received. And if I hover over these points, you will see the date, the time, and the number of calls received. So for example, on the 10th of December at 17 hours, the number of calls received were 16. And then at 18 hours, the number of calls went up to 26. And then at 19 hours, the number of calls went down to 20. Now for any workload planning, we need to know what is the peak workload expected so that we can plan sufficient resources. Now let's look at some of the peaks. So we have a peak over here, which has occurred on the 11th of December at 17 hours. And then we have another peak, which has occurred on the 12th of December at 19 hours. And here we have a peak, which has occurred on the 14th of December at 18 hours. Now, just looking at this graph, it is very difficult to make sense out of it because it is not very smooth and there are lots and lots of variations. Now, let's apply the fast Fourier transformation algorithms to this data. Here is the result of the fast Fourier transformation, which helps to discover repeating and smooth signals in the time series data. The line curve, which is shown in orange, is the smooth and repeating signal which has been found by the fast Fourier transformation algorithm. And this signal, it starts around 7 o'clock in the morning and then it goes up. It reaches the peak at around 19 hours and then it goes down and again it restarts at around 7 o'clock in the morning. This signal is much smoother compared to the original data and we can use it to make some workload planning. As per the signal, we should have minimum number of people around 7 o'clock in the morning. We then ramp up the capacity and we should reach the maximum capacity at around 19 hours. And then we reduce the number of people taking the calls and we restart in the morning at 7 o'clock. So as you can see that the fast Fourier transformation is very useful to convert noisy data into smooth signals which are easy to interpret and take actions. Alright my friends, hope you have enjoyed the video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comment section below how would you use time series analytics. See you soon in the next video.